All right, Rich, thank you. Now let's send it over to ABC 15's Navita Fergani, who's in Mesa. Navita, I understand there's a lot of flooding where you are.
Stephanie, I've literally been all over the valley, and a lot of places got hit pretty hard. Right now, I'm at Broadway near Power, and you can take a look at just how strong the aftermath was of this water coming through 2.5 feet of dirt, completely removed, exposing the irrigation system and the roots. Now, earlier today, I was actually in Apache Junction, where water just took over the streets. One neighbor in particular was a retirement community, and a canal was literally flowing through the community. Now, fortunately for these neighbors in this area where the water had just taken over, their homes were built high enough so they weren't harmed by the water.
I went and I looked out the door right away, came out the door and looked through there, and the water was way up here already. And I said, oh boy, we got a good one. And the way I understand it, there's supposed to be some more coming.
And to give you a better perspective, take a look right over there, right in the center of this canal. You see a car almost completely submerged in the water. Now, I'm told the roads on both sides were closed, but that driver decided to risk it, and now he's stuck. Now, it's going to rain all weekend, and that right there is a reminder, if you don't want to end up like him, don't go through washes, don't go through flooded areas, don't risk it. If you think you have to go someplace, you can wait, because you're going to end up stranded and getting rescued like a lot of folks had to be today. Stephanie?
Yeah, Navita, just a reminder, if drivers do go around those road barriers, as you'd mentioned, and they did get stuck, they're going to have to end up paying for their own rescue as part of the stupid motorist law. That can be up to $2,000, so it can be quite expensive as well.
That Navita, is expensive.
Yeah, thanks for your report.